What did you, oh, can you speak? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I'm doing another edition of Weekly Wishlist or Washout. If you're new to my channel, or if you haven't seen any of these before, what I do is, hopefully every week, go through all the new beauty releases from the past week and go over whether I think I'm going to add them to my wish list, meaning do I think I'm probably going to try to buy them at some point, or if I think they're a washout and for whatever reason I'm not interested. So if you like weekly wish list or washout, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to catch the rest of my videos as they come out. So let's go ahead and jump in. Like always, I'll be taking all of my photos and information from Trend Mood's Instagram page, which I will link down below. The first thing I see is a luxury product from Guerlain, which is the terracotta bronzer. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of like two-tone products, especially when it comes to bronzer. I'm very, very conservative when it comes to bronzer or contour. I'll barely do like on an everyday basis, you know, enough to show up and just define. I don't really like anything glittery, and I don't like anything like multicolored, and this has like a pink and a yellow in it, so it's gonna be a hard pass. Also, I'm sure it's like expensive. Like, I would not be surprised if this is like $80 for the bronzer. I mean, that might even be cheap. Next, I see some new releases from Kylie Cosmetics. Well, they're re-releases, actually. It's the Wet Set Highlighting Palette, and then two of like her lip glosses that were really popular, I guess, last summer season. I actually thought about getting the Wet Set, but then I looked online and I saw how much it was, you know, plus shipping, and I'm not gonna pay upwards of $70, $80 for one highlighting palette. I already have some of her highlighters, you know, I like them, but I don't feel the need to get this set. And then also the glosses. I've tried a few of her like lip kits, and honestly, I did not really like them. They felt really like tight, and it kind of turned me off all of her like liquid lip products. I have a couple of her bullet lipsticks, and those are okay, but even they feel like fairly drying as well. So all of those are also a hard pass. Urban Decay is coming out with what looks like a new Afterglow highlighting palette, and it has like some, or like one blush, like a rosy highlight, a dark, I guess it's supposed to be, yeah, it's supposed to be a highlighter. I rarely wear blush. I actually just picked up like my first blush palette because I wanted to try and get into it a little bit more. I got it at TJ Maxx. I actually got an Anastasia blush kit from TJ Maxx for $19. So I don't think it's that bad of a deal considering the original was like $35, $40. I have one like salmon kind of color, two deep pinks, and then like a bright pink. So that's kind of what I'm using now to break into blush. But overall, I'm not a huge fan. And basically, I've been turned off of any face palette that includes a blush since I know I'm not really gonna use it. So the Urban Decay palette is gonna be a no for me. It also looks like at least half of the highlighters are too dark for my skin tone anyway. Sephora is coming out with another one of their like little mini palettes. It's called the Pro Pigment Palette in Metallic. This actually looks really pretty. You've got like a nice like green, olive green, that one is really calling to me. I like that red. I really like that like gunmetal silver. So I'm gonna think about this one. It's only $20. You get the six shades. I mean, it says limited edition. I'm not sure how true that's gonna be, but I'll keep it on my radar. Ooh, there's a new Melt Stack coming out. This is a like a brand that I've been meaning to try out. But this melt, like the stack was such like a letdown. Like a lot of these colors, like they look like the same color almost. I was expecting something not warm neutral, to be honest. I don't know. I will try Melt at some point, just not this stack. ColourPop is like flying over themselves, coming out with new stuff. I see a whole bunch of like blush and highlighter palettes, which I've gotten one of those palettes before and I really didn't like it. The bronzer was really orange and the highlighter was way too dark. So that's kind of put me off since I see a lot of these are either like neon pink or really orange or pink. I definitely won't pick up any of those face palettes. I actually already placed an order with ColourPop. I picked up some of their new Luxe lipsticks and a few of, I actually ordered it a while ago, and I guess they've been busy. I'm about to like email and check up on that order because it's been a while and I haven't gotten I got a confirmation email, but I haven't gotten like a shipping email yet, so I'm not sure when that's gonna come in. So there was like a sneak peek for the Agent Carter and Besame collaboration. It's coming out April 23rd. Honestly, I'd really be interested in this, especially if it came out with like a nice, comfortable red liquid lip. I'd be all over that. Though I really don't know like what else they're doing in the collection, because I see her makeup and I know like the most iconic part is like her red lipstick. So there's gotta be a red lipstick in it. I'm just not sure what else they're actually going to come out with, but you know, whatever it is, I'm pretty interested in it. Also, because I haven't tried Besame before, I know they come out with a bunch of cute like collaboration collections, and this is the first one that I've actually been like interested in. Ooh, Kim Kardashian is coming out with Conceal, Bake, Brighten. Concealer in 16 shades, baking powder, and a brightening powder. It's $80 for the kit of what you need. It's a concealer, a baking powder, a brightening powder, and her brushes. That's $80. No, I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. I just can't. That's a ridiculous amount of money. And from what like her past products have been, how much are you actually getting in there? Yeah. I mean, I'll hold judgment on the actual products until they come out and I see reviews, but I'm not gonna run out the day of and pick that up. Oh, one that was a bit of a letdown, if I'm being really honest. It's from Dose of Colors, their new Set the Tone Matte Cream Eyeliner. Like, they released like a sneak peek a while ago of like half of their shades, and it was like these, like this really nice dark burgundy and like these like mauve and a black, and they said it was half the collection, and so everyone was like, oh, so the other half is gonna be like really neon and colorful and pretty, right? They released the other half and they're all warm neutrals. Like, if I'm gonna like specifically buy a separate eyeliner, it's going to be bright, because I have my go-to black eyeliners, I have my go-to neutral eyeliners. If I'm gonna go out and buy like a specific pot, like the Kylie one, like the Kylie eyeliner, this is in yellow and it's actually like a bright yellow. I've been testing out all the new products from her new like Stormy collection, and I really like this eyeliner. It's opaque, it actually goes on well over shadow, and it looks yellow. Like, it's a nice eyeliner. So spoiler alert for that upcoming review, but what I'm saying is for a pot eyeliner, for me to go out of my way to do something different with eyeliner, I want something different. And these just really aren't different enough. I don't think they went far enough with these. A product that I know I'm not going to get because I saw it in store and I tried it is actually the new limited edition photo finish primer water from Smashbox. I put, it was the green one, not the coconut, it was the Serene Greens. I sprayed that one on my face at Ulta. One of the worst decisions I have ever made. It smelled like someone smacked me in the face with kale. Like, if someone walked up to me in Whole Foods, had a bunch of kale, and just smacked me in the face, that's what it smelled like. It was horrible. Like, I actually walked over and sprayed another setting spray on my face just to get rid of the smell. It was unbelievable. And the other scents are coconut and citrus. I didn't even try them because I was so, like, off-put from this one. I really don't like coconut. I don't like the smell. I mean, if it's next to real coconut. Like, the coconut that's in the Too Faced products doesn't smell like real coconut. It's like obviously fake coconut. I can deal with that. But if it smells like actual real coconut, like as realistic as this green one did, then there's no way in hell I could use these. So I wouldn't really recommend those unless like you want to rub lettuce or kale or broccoli all over your face, then yeah, pick it up. And we've reached the end. That is everything for this week's weekly wishlist or washout. What do you think about these releases? Are you gonna pick any of them up? Are any on your wishlist? I know most of them are negative, so let me know what you think down below. And don't forget to like this while you're down there and hit that subscribe button and the little bell icon so you're notified whenever I post a new video. And I hope I'll see you in my next one. Bye.